Hello, this video is part 1 of cluster-to-cluster storage replica within the same region in Azure. In this part, we will set up clusters in Azure such that they are ready for storage replica. But first, let's have a quick look at the different components required for the whole setup and how they come together. We have a resource group which contains all our resources required for this setup: a virtual network, a network security group, availability set, one for each cluster. This helps you to logically separate and manage the resources for two clusters. Storage account, one for each cluster. Load balancer, one for each cluster. For this part, we will set up two-node clusters, so 4 nodes, and 1 node for domain controller. All of the resources are in Azure and within the same region. To make sure the cluster can talk to each other seamlessly, we will use load balancers and configure them such that they allow all high availability ports. And in the part 2, we will configure storage replica to replicate data from one cluster to another. Now, let's create and connect each resource one by one. First, create a resource group. Go to your Azure portal. Under resource groups, add a new group, let's say SRAZ2AZ. I'll use West US 2 region. Create. Here is our newly created group. Now, let's create availability sets. AZ2AZ S1 and AZ2AZ AS2. Back to the portal. Create availability set. AZ2AZ AS1. Add it to the existing group SRAZ2AZ in the same region. As per your requirements, choose the fault domains and update domains and create. Similarly, create another availability set AZ2AZ AS2. Now, let's create virtual network. AZ2AZ VNet. Add it to the existing group SRAZ2AZ in the same region and create. Now, let's create network security group. AZ2AZ NSG, add it to the existing group and create. Now, let's add inbound security rule for RDP. Add basic, select RDP, okay. Now, let's create 4 nodes for 2-node cluster and a node for domain controller. Back to the portal, our first node AZ2AZ1, add it to the existing group. Okay. Select a machine size. Add this to our first availability set. Select our previously created virtual network. Create a standard public IP address. This is required to create the standard load balancer. Select the previously created network security group. Okay. Create. Similarly, I went ahead and created all the other nodes. Remember to add AZ2AZ1 and AZ2AZ2 in first availability set. You can choose to create another availability set for your domain controller. For For this demo, I'm simply adding my domain controller in my first availability set. And AZ2 AZ3 and AZ2 AZ4 in second availability set. To enable storage spaces direct, we need to add this to each of the cluster node. So in first node, go to disks, add data disk, create disk, give it a name and size, create. I added two disks to each of the cluster nodes and made my host caching read-write. Now, let's configure domain controller. I RDP to my domain controller. Let's install the feature Active Directory Domain Server. And promote this server to a domain controller. I created a forest called contoso.com and added a new administrator called contoso admin. The IP address of my domain controller is 10.3.0.8. We have to update the virtual network DNS server with that IP address. In our virtual network DNS server, add the IP address and save. I went ahead and joined all my nodes to the contoso.com domain and added contoso admin as administrator user in all the nodes and then logged in as contoso admin from all the nodes. Let's prepare our nodes to create cluster and storage replica. Install failover cluster and storage replica in all the cluster nodes. Now, let's create the cluster. Let's name the first cluster as SRAZC1 with the nodes AZ2 AZ1 and AZ2 AZ2. The static IP address 10.3.0.100 is one of the unused IP address from the virtual network subnet. Similarly, create second cluster as SRAZC2 with the nodes AZ2 AZ3 and AZ2 AZ4 and give it the static IP address 10.3.0.101. Now, let's enable storage spaces direct on both the cluster. This takes a couple of minutes to finish. Let's do this for second cluster. I created two virtual disk and volume for each cluster. One for data, another for log for storage replica. For both cluster, add data disk to cluster shared volume. I have renamed the shared cluster storage at data disk 1 and data disk 2. Now let's create load balancers. Say AZLBR1 internal standard, select our virtual network, select subnet. Provide the static IP address of our first cluster 10.3.100, add it to the resource group. Create. Once it is created, let's add backend pools. Select our virtual network, add the virtual machines linked to this cluster. Now, let's add health probe to port 59999. Okay. Now let's add load balancing rule. Allow HA ports. Enable floating IP. Okay. Similarly, I created another load balancer AZLBR2 for cluster SRAZ-C2. Let's quickly review. Looks good. On each cluster node, open port 59999 for health probe. I have done this on all the other nodes. Now, we have to instruct the cluster to listen for health probe messages on port 59999 and respond from the node that currently owns this resource. Run these command and bring the cluster offline and online again. Similarly, do this for other cluster as well. Now, let's create Cloud Witness for our clusters. For this, we need to create storage accounts. Say AZ2 AZCW, add it to the existing group. Create. Once it is created, open it, access keys, copy account name and keys. Now configure cluster quorum settings. Quorum witness, cloud witness, paste, finish. Now, we have a Cloud Witness. Similarly, I went ahead and created the Cloud Witness for cluster SRAZ-C2. Make sure clusters can communicate or see each other. Now, the clusters in Azure are ready for storage replica. For more information and commandlets used in this video, go to these URLs. See you in part 2 of this video. Thanks for watching.